We have a mini-split air conditioner that is running at 16 degrees, but the issue is that the unit keeps turning off repeatedly. I have opened the outdoor unit and its fan motor is starting, but the compressor is not turning on. So let's check why the compressor isn't starting and determine the cause. After observing it for a while, an error appeared on the indoor unit, so we'll analyze that error and understand why the compressor isn't starting. Now you can see that the outdoor fan motor has started, but the compressor has not. Let's check what error the indoor unit displays so that we can work on resolving the issue accordingly. What's happening now is that the unit has tried to start the compressor 6 to 7 times and the fan motor starts and then shuts off. The reason behind this is indicated by the error code displayed. The unit's display is now showing an E9 error, meaning the unit has identified the issue as E9 and it now needs to be fixed. Now you can see that the indoor blower motor is continuously running. Even if you leave it for hours, it will keep displaying the error and the blower motor will continue to run. Whenever such a problem occurs, it is essential to check the unit's electrical supply. Often, issues like this arise because if there's a problem with the electricity, such as low voltage, the unit will face difficulties. The compressor will try to start but won't be able to. That's why checking the electrical supply is very important. Other functions of the unit may still work, even with low voltage, but the compressor will not operate. Now let me explain that the reason for the error could be either the PCB or the compressor itself being faulty. But how can we determine which component is at fault? First of all, check if the wires are properly connected. If the wires are disconnected for any reason, the unit will show an E9 error. Similarly, if the wire connected to the compressor is loose, or if the compressor is jammed, this issue can also arise. Additionally, if the compressor's winding is broken, it could result in the E9 error. In case of a short circuit, the IPM, intelligent power module, could also be damaged, and this could be due to the compressor being faulty. These are the key points to check when diagnosing this problem. If we talk about what could go wrong with the PCB and why the E9 error might appear, there are several possibilities. Previously, I made a video about a similar PCB issue where the PCB was damaged for the first time, causing a short circuit throughout the unit, resulting in an E0 error. However, the second time, when I supplied power to it, the unit turned on. Now, let's understand this in detail. The IPM, intelligent power module, drives the compressor, and the entire compressor drive area on the PCB is critical. Several components in this area can fail, leading to issues. For example, 1. Heavy short circuit. If there's a severe short circuit, the high side of the circuit can get damaged. In such cases, the PCB becomes completely dead, and the unit displays the E0 error because communication between components is lost. If the PCB powers on but cannot drive the compressor, the problem could be due to a shorted IGBT or diodes in the compressor drive circuit, failure in the low side of the IPM, such as a damaged resistor or transistor. Certain components like resistors or capacitors in the circuit lack a sensing system. If these fail, the PCB won't detect their condition but will still generate the E9 error due to improper compressor operation. Another potential cause for the E9 error is related to the voltage required to drive the low side of the system. The system requires 5 volts and 15 volts for operation. If either of these voltages is missing, the system will not function properly, resulting in the E9 error. Additionally, consider these specific points. There are 3 capacitors in the circuit. If any of these become short-circuited or fail to function, the system will also trigger the E9 error. Similarly, if the filter capacitors become shorted, the unit may still appear to work, but the compressor will not drive, leading to the E9 error. If the compressor itself cannot be driven because of issues in the associated capacitors, diodes, or missing voltages, the system will continuously display the E9 error. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.